All right, I'm back. I'm not sure exactly. I know when it cut off, I heard the beep in my ear, but I don't know where I was exactly in my notes here. I'm pretty close because I was talking about the what must the sky must be spoken here to be thinking that all this stuff is there. And I talked about day number 237, of course, today 827 waypoint, being this prophecy for the story of Ezra, of course, 237 with those three arrows. And then I said, but what does Strong's number 827 mean? And I pointed out that it means quiver for the arrows. And he calls these children arrows in Psalms 127, which is what in Yellowstone time, that's what time they originally said that Steamboat blew yesterday, but they changed it to 126, which was significant for Psalms 126. So I think we had a reason for doing that as well. But the whole thing's amazing. But the Stone of Ezel, amazing. Stone, you got stone. Oh, stone. He must be stoned, right? Really, he just keeps all this stuff keeps matching up. 827 for quiver, but Stone of Ezel, stone. Strong's number 68 of Ezel. Departure, 237 for today. Number 827 is day number 237. 827 is quiver. Okay, stone. Stone. What's Strong's number for stone? 68. What's Strong's number in Aramaic for stone? 69. Last night he caused both 68 and 69 to be drawn on the heels of today. Yeah, I mean on the eve of today. Say what? Caused them both to be drawn of the five balls, 68 and 69, of those five smooth stones. Amazing. Stone of departure parallels the pool of departure. The waters journey forth softly in Isaiah chapter 8, the Maher-Shalal Hushpaz prophecy. They drew it first softly from his pool of departure, the lower pool, the pool of Shiliom, the pool of departure. Wow, that pool that was dug up there, which is amazing, below his house. Amazing. They've thus far joined, what's Steamboat 142, 328, softly for the Ark Throne waypoint. For the Sign of the Dove waypoint, spit me out of the belly of the ocean traversing plain on 328, and the first calculation of both yesterday's steamboat eruption and the 142nd eruption before that were both 328 for the first time ever. So yesterday was the second for the 211 I talked about in part one. I'm just going to call this part one, part two, so I don't have to re-record that because I had some good stuff in there and plus I went on for a while. But day number 88 of the year, amazing how that tied into to this with the 88th seal tonight. You just can't make it up. Truly amazing. Stone. 68. Strong number 68. Strong number 69. Both draws last night. Today, day number 237 of the year for the three-year-old prophecy of Jonas shooting. Stone of Ezel is only mentioned one place, and it's in those with association with those three arrows. Three man-childs. Calls it Psalms 127. Calls them. That calls these children of his holy seed arrows. Quiver, 827. Strong's number for quiver. You can't make it up. You just can't make it up. Last night, six ball total was 250. Ties into all this stuff now. Dog, the guy that Dwayne Chapman or whatever, they call it the dog bounty hunter, the dog. Now searching for this Brian Laundrie guy. The way he's tied his whole thing with everything in the news, but his whole thing with the Gabby lady and this Brian guy into this and the manhunt in relation to Chiefway's anointed and different things with the stories I don't get into. But the $250 price tag of the dog is why the price tag of a dog and the price of the whore is how they ended up searching for finding Chiefway's anointed, had returned to Zion to blow the silver trumpet assembly. He had a $250 reward out for that dog. And last night's six ball total was 250. You say, well, that's a coincidence. Really, with Korah, with his 250 men that rose up against him, that 250 censers that were beaten into the covering of Yahweh's altar, and his altar is standing before your faces. Yeah, that's all a coincidence, but it's the 250th night from the first draw tonight. So that's all just a coincidence. 250 draws later, $250 price of tag of a dog, all has been taught, and price of a whore, all been talked about in other videos, for the search for Yahweh's anointed, and now the dog has been brought on, been unleashed on, the dog has been unleashed on Brian. And of course, he has no place to hide. If he's in the belly of an alligator, he can't hide there because he's going to be resurrected to the judgment. He has no place to hide, neither do the rest of you. That's just a fact. Today is not only 400 days from 717, as talked about in part one. This makes it 40 days from 717 of this year, since there's 360 days a year of a smooth stone, 360 degrees in a smooth circle, in a perfect circle. For 717, Art Part Noah Marked Waypoint, the Sarah Sand of the Seashore Dream, which is about me going down to cash these tickets with the pin. Talked about that in another video with the haboob and stuff down there. And there's been another haboob dream yesterday morning. Quite amazing. It tied into things, and it was quite the second haboob dream. But that day was Silver Trumpet Assembly number 434, which is parallels the 62 sevens of the 407 I talked about, which is also the 483rd day when you look of the 490, or the 434th, the more you look at it. But that day was the 227th seal of these wines. Bottle up. All the bottles be filled, Jeremiah 13. Got to watch part one to get to this point, obviously, because to understand it. 227, he opened the door to the three tiers of the boat on 227. That day was the third day of the seventh, the third day of the 7/14-day feast. With 7 days of feast, that's extended to 14 for the 12th stroke of 14 days. Amazing how that tied into this. But 400 days ago on the 717 waypoint began my exceedingly long Daniel toothache, which has since ended. On 723, I lost the 12th tooth, which was the 13th tooth total, because there was one lost at 409. But since he brought us to Zion, to his holy mountain, there have been 12 teeth lost total. 9 were put in the door. 3 of them were lost at the Mount of Olives after the fact that four were lost at the Mount of Olives, actually, but one of them was still put in the door. But 9 were put in the door and 3 were not for the 903 waypoint. We completed this morning at 7:34 a.m. We completed 1,293 days from the 7:34 a.m. clock on 124, the Daniel chapter 10 waypoint. Strong number 1293 is a blessing. Comes from 1288, which means to bless. Are you a blessing to Capeway? I talked about the beginning of part one. Are you blessing to him? Bless those who bless Israel, curse those who curse Israel. And of course, you're riding on this. You think you're good to go with him because you're riding on the curtails of the prophecy of Balak. Balaam taught Balaam to bless Israel, I talked about. You write all the blessings. You think you're just so blessed. You think you're good to go. So forget that. Are you a blessing to Capeway? Are you blessed at Capeway by being a blessing to his anointed? His second son of his holy anointing oil, who he sent here in this poor and desolate manner to test you and to prove you, which you failed miserably, except for 3 of you now that aren't stealing from Capeway. Actually, might be down to 2, because I haven't, the man from Sweden, he hasn't sent his tithe this month, and maybe something's happened to him and he's not able to. He hasn't written me, so I don't know. So it become public knowledge. It could be one other time he was delayed, so maybe he's just delayed, but it might be down to 2. I hope, I really sincerely hope, because it saddens me that Malachi just tests me now in this, Yahweh says, his test. And it saddened me much because I have great feelings for all 3 of these, because Yahweh's called them to do this. And so I hope he hadn't went away, but haven't heard from him, so might be down to 2. So we'll see. I wasn't planning on putting that in there, but if you're listening, Victor, I hope you're okay, but if you're okay, actually, I guess I hope you're not okay, really, because if you're okay, then you should be writing. So I guess I'd be better off for you to be not okay, because you're not okay if you're able to do this and to not steal from him, but to be a blessing to his anointed. But how are you blessed, Capeway? By you being a blessing to him, by living in rebellion to him? That's really blessing him. Thumbing your nose at his statutes and his boundaries and his judgments. Yeah, that's being a blessing to him, isn't it? Living in rebellion to him, not turning back to his restored Sabbaths and such, and the rest of his restored appointed time. Yeah, you're really being a blessing to him, aren't you? But today is day number 1293. That's for the blessing. I thought that's cool. About 1 o'clock today, which is coming up here soon, complete 2020, hindsight's 2020, 2020 days from the heart attack. Amazing. Strong number 2020 is just used in one place, Esther 4:14, where Mordecai told Hadassah or Esther that if you don't do this, deliverance will rise up from someplace else. It means deliverance. But 2020, hi, great Meher Shalal Kushbaz Meher for today. About 1 o'clock this afternoon too, about the time I would have got, I'm not sure, I didn't write down the time at the time, but I would have got spit out of the belly of the plane, his side of the dove, at an ocean traversing plane, on 3,389 days ago today. About 1 o'clock would be complete 3,389 days when the sign of the dove was spit out of the belly of the plane. Strong number 3389 is Jerusalem. Hey, Yeshua said, Jerusalem, Jerusalem, how often I had gathered you as a hen gathers her chicks, but you wouldn't. You stoned the prophets, he says. You kill those who Yahweh sent to you. How that ties into my being in the tomb. What do you see in the news now? Every day I just take pictures every day. There's three or four on Fox News anyway. It's the only one I pretty much look at, but $3.5 trillion spending plan they're trying to get approved for 3.5 days. This is it, folks. It's accompanying this, and it's going to tie into the Stone of Ezel prophecy, I'm sure, because the one stone of Zechariah 3 standing for your faces, Ezel departure, the pool departure, waters the journey for softly thus far, part of his manual. 7 days from today is the 9-4 waypoint, means the children be born that night before. 7 days completed, 7:34 a.m., from 7:34 a.m. this morning, 7 days from this morning, on the morning of 9:04, 3389, Jerusalem, Jerusalem, Jerusalem. How often would I gather you as the hen does gather her chicks, but you wouldn't listen. Circumcision tonight, seal number 88 for that 328 day, that day number 88 of the year of his restored calendar when he spit me out of the belly of the ocean traversing plane for his sign of the dove, aka the sign of Jonah. Jonah 3,389 days ago for Jerusalem, Jerusalem. Seal number 88 tonight, will be circumcised. Sign of the dove. You guys think Jerusalem's the physical land of Jerusalem? Jerusalem means dual teachers of completeness. We're here to teach you to become complete before Yahweh's faces. The physical land of Jerusalem and here. And Yahweh's word clearly justifies that the America is the chief seat of the scattered descendants of Israel, where he spit me out of the belly of the Trojan traversing plain, which is Jerusalem. Prophetically, America is Jerusalem, period. That's just what his word testifies to. The chief seat of the scattered descendants of Israel, period. The country of America, where he spit his sign of the dove out of the belly of the plain 3,389 days ago for the Strong's number for Jerusalem. Jerusalem, Jerusalem, how often I would have gathered you as the hen does gather chicks, but you wouldn't. 328, wow. Yesterday's steamboat, 143-11. First calculation for the number 328. For the second time, for the gold of Ophir. The gold. The gold is mine, the silver is mine, says Yahweh of Hosts. So, is that the end of the notes? Six? No, I got one more, I think. No, I got... This gets bigger print, though, but yeah. Steamboat was originally 1227 for bottle up. The word 1227, bottle up, part one. Amazing, but they changed it to 1226 Arizona time, which ties into lots of stuff, but the 26 minutes after that was amazing because that's six days and five minutes after the summer ended of Jeremiah chapter 8. All bottles will be filled, 175 plus 175 of the 175 of the new wine, Jeremiah 13, 350 bottles, Noah's vineyard, amazing. Noah lived for 350 years after the flood. Jeremiah's belt, amazing. Here you get good for nothing, hidden underneath the, in a hole underneath the rock. One stone of Zechariah turns into all, don't you know that all the bottles will be filled? Again, David, bottle up when he fled from Absalom. 6 minute eruption, 821, day brought me to the world plus 6 days is today. David was fled much of his life, folks. Do you know, that's just reality. I mean, that's just a, it's just reality. I mean, he ruled in Jerusalem 33 years, in Hebron 7.5 years for 40 and one half years. But reality is, and from basically time shortly, probably before he was 20 even, that to the time he was, so he started ruling, all those 33, 40 years would have been 30 when he started ruling, because he died at 70. So anyway, 10 years or so, 10 or 12 years, he was fled. That's a good portion of his life. He only lived to 70. I mean, that's 10 years out of 70 is quite a bit. But he was in the land of the Philistines for an unspecified time, fled from Saul for an unspecified amount of days and 4 months. That's just reality. So 427, Moses' 40th day. I talked about 427, my mom, and Moses' 40th day in the last couple videos. 427 plus Moses' 40th day plus 4 months. And I am Moses, part one. It testifies that as well, but it's just what it is. His second Exodus is at hand. But 427 plus 4 months is today. The Stone of Ezra waypoint, day number 237. Amazing. Absalom, just 200 shekels of hair. I just thought I'd run that in because you get into the plot. Abigail tied into yesterday's eruption because Abigail is 26, Strong's number 26, and it was 26 minutes after noon, or 26 minutes into the afternoon, the p.m. portion, if you will, on Gateway's, where Gateway's prison up his house in Arizona. But Absalom had 200 shekels of hair he shaved off every year, but Abigail brought those 200s of provision stuff for David for the feast and his men. But today minus 200 days is 207. The seven laps around the stench of a month on the seventh day was 207, with John Jericho means the stench of a month. Your stenches of a month are your profaning of our Maker's appointed times. Again, are you a blessing to him by profaning his appointed times? Yeah. You're blessing him, big time blessing him, ain't you? Constantly blessing, doing his desire constantly, aren't you? Yeah, you're just seeking to do, all I want to do is obey Gateway so I can be a blessing to him. Not, all I want to do is obey Gateway so I can be a blessing to him. Yeah, yeah, that's just a fact. And the wife that's fled in the wilderness, all she wants to do is obey Gateway to be a blessing to him. Yeah, how about you? Any of you? Well, I want to, but I just don't do it. That would apply to a couple people anyway, possibly. But do you really want to? If you really want to bad enough, you'll do it. When David fled from Absalom, he went to where they mounted up their recapture battle. Went to Mahanaim to do dual camps. That spells the here and the now big time with the dual camp, since we've had to flee. The events of David's life certainly indicate completely, not just that our waiting time, because he said he'd wait on him, even part of the Meher Shalakish Bezbel, our waiting time is just about up, folks. And the remaining 73 bottles will soon be ordered. The money's going to get here. It's amazing. And those 73 bottles extra will take us from 9-11 to 11-24, which is where the 280 begins and ends on 9-04. And then plus the 7 days for the encompassing 9-04, for the circumcision on 9/11, I talked about part one. But the high priest girdle, number 73. Wow. The girdle that I'm going to be given, the Isaiah 22 girdle, the value determiner that hewed out the judge, that hewed out the tomb for me. Wow. We'll be bottled up indeed. That's amazing, because the 70 bottles are going to be ordered. The 350 bottles will be complete, to be exact, for the 350 years of as it was in the days of Noah's vineyard. Upon the mountains of Ararat, the first of these bottles was a bottle of pomegranate wine from the mountains of Ararat. Oh yeah, you just planned that. You get talked about, I think part one, when I get disconnected because I ran out of memory. I don't know if I said that or not, but the phone got full, so I had to delete some stuff. Yeah, this guy must just be stoned. I'm so against that product, it's not even funny, because it's a mind-altering thing. But he must be stoned because to think of all this stuff. But he must have went and got that bottle of wine from the mountains of Ararat to plant it. No, it was a gift. The lady there from South Carolina with those 229 plates even brought it here. Now, I didn't even know, I never even heard of pomegranate wine. But right there, a bottle of the mountains of Ararat. The first of these 350 bottles when Jeremiah 13, all bottles will be filled. We'll be bottled up indeed with 350 bottles. But his vineyard will be full, finally. Noah's vineyard that he planted that day at the curse reverse. And there have been 779 nights with no wine on account of you stealing from Gateway. The curse is Strong's number 779. And Ararat means the curse will be reversed. Yeah, we're going to be bottled up indeed. Sounds like you're going to be day late and a dollar short, because he's going to send the money for us to be bottled up another way. That's just another fact.